Hi, we're here today to talk to you about the development of an online lunch ordering system for Sydney Star Primary School. In particular today, we've been focusing on functional requirements and what we wanted the system to be able to do. In doing that, we've come up with 10 that we think are the most important at this stage of development. These include the ability to register an account and add a student to that account. Then the user needs to be able to log into the account, browse a menu, review the order, modify quantity of the order, place the order, and get a confirmation from that order. Also, the staff at SSPC Live School, Primary School, need to be able to review these orders and implement advertising. Now we're going to talk about the individual parts we've worked on. I pass it over to my teammates.
Hi, I'm Kevin. The two parts I focus on are register accounts and dealing with the order fees. So let me introduce something about the register. As the result shows, this school only uses school students and their parents to register, so they must provide students ID first, and then provide some personal details such as a name, contact number, or email address. Also, it allows a student account to link with each other. It's more easier for their parents to control the ordering procedure. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Edison, and in my part, I analyze the login to account and view the orders. This part is mainly for the attending staff that they have enough time to prepare the food. But today I want to talk about the login to account because I think this step is the most important thing even in the functional requirement. Look at this diagram. Customer can do the other requirement only when they finish the login account, and this can support different device for customers. So this is the fourth stone of all the functional requirement.
I worked on the browse menu and the place order functional requirements. In particular, I'm going to talk about the browse menu. Essentially, what this function provides to the user is the ability to look through the menu, look at each product's picture, name, price, and nutritional requirements, and thereby make an informed decision as to what they want to order. This functional requirement also adds the ability to filter results of products, so you can filter the products based on their price or their nutritional content, for example. As you can see, this browse menu also includes the ability to modify quantity of each item, which is the use case that Himika will talk about in more detail now.
Okay, I'm Himika. So I'm talking about modify quantity. So the function, this function mainly to modify the quantity, edit the number of the item and limit the number of the item. The user sets the number of zero, so the system automatically removes the items. So this is the automatic flow. So this is the main function. Yeah.
I'm Mandy, and today we talked about the implement advertising. The implement advertising is a requirement that has a good priority. This is mainly because that the implement advertising is not essentially critical to the operation of the lunch ordering system, but rather it's a desirable, and it allows the staff of SSPS to communicate with the consumer, which in this case are the students and the parents. The communication allows them to provide information about the following week's specials and also the price. This allows the parents or the students to make informed decisions whether or not to order a food item over another particular food item. So looking here, we have the UML diagram, which essentially summarizes the 10 functional requirements as you can see here. So just to briefly recap, the customer, in this case is the student and the parents, they have the ability to register an account, and in the case where there is a additional student that could be associated, this register account can extend to add student. Now, the customer can then log into their created account to browse the menu with all the food items and provide them the necessary information to order, and also allows them to modify the quantity of foods ordered. And then following here, we have the review order, and then this gives the customers an opportunity to finalize everything, and then finally place the order and confirm the order. And here we have the employee, which is referring to the SSPS staff. Here you can see that they have the implement advertising and also the view orders functional requirements. And this overall summarizes our 10 functional requirements for the SSPS lunch ordering system. Thank you.